Hi, I'm Alli, the founder of Stratia, and I'm back with another scientific deep dive into the science of skincare. If you've enjoyed our videos so far, remember to subscribe so that you get notified every time we come out with a new one. Today we're going to be talking about transepidermal water loss, which is something you may have seen floating around in the skincare sphere. Transepidermal water loss is essentially a measure of how much water is evaporating out through your skin. Trans in this context means through. Epidermal refers to the epidermis, the outermost layer of your skin. Transepidermal water loss is used in scientific studies as an objective measure of the skin's health, how strong your moisture barrier is, since your skin's primary function is really to keep water from evaporating. As you know, your body is about 60% water, and that water is constantly trying to evaporate. Your skin is there to keep it all in so that all of your organs and processes can keep functioning as they need to. Scientists measure transepidermal water loss by placing a sensor on the surface of the skin that measures the density of water vapor. So the denser it is, essentially, the more water is being lost through the surface of your skin. This measurement is extremely sensitive to environmental factors like humidity and temperature. It also varies wildly depending on where on your body it's measuring. So the transepidermal water loss on your cheek is going to be totally different from a measurement on your forearm. That means it's basically impossible to measure at home. It has to be done in a scientific lab environment. That said, it's an extremely useful measurement of skin barrier and moisture barrier health. High transepidermal water loss is the bad one. You want it to be as low as possible. So a high transepidermal water loss can come from pathology, something, a diagnosis like eczema, which is just a malfunction in your skin's ability to function as a barrier. It can come from products, you know, using high pH cleansers, over exfoliating, using harsh scrubs. It can also come from physical damage. So things like burns, sunburns, anything that does actual damage to the outermost layers of your skin. Since transepidermal water loss is the best objective measurement of skin barrier health, when we're evaluating new ingredients or products for their ability to repair a barrier, we actually need to manually damage the moisture barrier first so that we can see how well it's repairing. Scientists do that usually with one of two methods. One is called tape stripping, which is exactly what it sounds like. You just take tape, put it on the skin and rip it off. And that will take off a layer of skin cells and damage temporarily the skin's ability to prevent transepidermal water loss. The other traditional way is by cleansing using a harsh SLS, sodium lauryl sulfate cleanser, which will also remove a layer of skin and really damage its ability to prevent transepidermal water loss. That's also a really good signal that you should not be using super harsh foaming cleansers if it's literally being used to emulate skin damage in a scientific setting. When scientists measure transepidermal water loss, they're taking multiple readings from the exact same location, because remember, transepidermal water loss varies so wildly from place to place. So you measure the exact same location multiple times and you take the trend over time. You can't really compare one person's transepidermal water loss to another. You have to measure apples to apples. So taking the same reading from the same location on the same person will tell you whether or not barrier repair is happening, whether skin is getting healthier or less healthy. So generally, if you're seeing a scientific study that's showing barrier repair, skin health, anything of that nature, it's generally measuring based on transepidermal water loss. So given that it's a measurement of overall skin health, our goal is generally to reduce transepidermal water loss. We can't measure it at home, as I mentioned, but it's still a good thing to keep in mind as we are trying to find our healthiest, strongest skin. So there are two ways to decrease transepidermal water loss. One is short-term by creating an artificial barrier. You can use petroleum jelly, my favorite Aquaphor, anything that kind of creates a really strong film on the skin. I mean, technically you can use saran wrap. That'll reduce transepidermal water loss to zero. I wouldn't recommend it. Now, that's just a short-term solution, so you can use that, for example, overnight if you want to supplement your skin barrier. The long-term solution to reducing transepidermal water loss is by strengthening your skin barrier from the inside out. That means using ingredients with ceramides, cholesterol, and fatty acids, which are the three major components in your skin's natural moisture barrier. You can also cut back on exfoliation because exfoliants literally take off the top layers of your skin. So if you're trying to reduce transepidermal water loss, that's not something you want to be doing. You want a skincare routine that's rich in both humectants and emollients. So humectants are hydrating products, they draw water to themselves, and emollients are things like facial oils and creams, so that you're giving your skin a really diverse diet. And finally, you can't overstate the importance of sunscreen. Burns do so much damage to your skin's ability to prevent transepidermal water loss. In addition to all those other negative things like skin cancer, it can really damage your skin as a barrier, which is its primary function. So that's a brief overview of transepidermal water loss. You'll see it a lot in scientific studies, so I hope that this was a useful tool to help understand what those studies are talking about. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope this was helpful. Be sure to like and subscribe, comment below any topics that you want me to cover in future videos, any skincare science things you want illuminated. Be sure to follow us on all our social media at Stratia Skin, and I'll see you next time.